Hello everyone, this is Tanishka Narang from Bharti Vidyapeeth College of Engineering for Women. I am currently studying in my final year, and today I'm going to be presenting to you my DMW mini project, which is a spam message classifier. So the idea behind this project was that we have seen that many social networking sites have come up in the past decade, and their growth, the number of users on these sites has become very huge. That in turn is a reason which attracts spam messages on these sites, and thus there is a need for a classifier or for a model to be present which can detect that certain messages that are present, are they harmful or are they malicious, or will they cause any problem in the systems. So these sites have a very huge number of users, and half of the messages that are exchanged in them are basically unsolicited or spam. Also, a report published in March 2020 indicates that the number of globally sent email messages in a single day were as high as 306 billion messages. So 306 billion exchanges have happened on the internet through these websites, through these apps, and out of which almost 50% were predicted to be spam messages. And this number can and will grow about more by 55 billion in the next 4 to 5 years. So the next decade, we can see that this number can grow more than 20%. So I am using so what is spam? The term spam generally can refer to any unsolicited electronic communication, typically email or even SMS spam. And this is an unsolicited commercial bulk communication. This can also be sent in bulk. Any messages that are sent in bulk to the user can also be called a spam. And these can also be referred as junk email, right? So spam is basically an evolving threat, and there are many researches going on to reduce the threat of reduce spam threat, and creating classifier which can detect that messages are spam or not spam is a part of that same. There are some harmful effects that spam has on our social networking sites, and some of them are that it has negative consequences on the internet. It consumes our internet resources, it can clog mail servers, it can make all emails slow, and it can burden the ISPs. It can reduce the effectiveness of legitimate advertising, of course, and it wastes people's time. It can threaten the very utility of email as a form of communication. It can have negative impact on a user's reputation. There have been reports where these spam messages have caused users great losses or their identity thefts. So that is why spam needs to be detected and it needs to be protected. So the algorithm that I'm going to be using in this project is called as Naive Bayes algorithm. Naive Bayes has different algorithms under it, but the one that I compared the different ones, and then the conclusion that I came up to was that using multinomial Naive Bayes would be a better option, as it was giving better results, and that I will be showing you in the project further. So why Naive Bayes? Naive Bayes classifiers basically work by correlating the use of tokens, words which are separated out in the sentences, and then probability is calculated of the occurrence of these words in our message as spam or not spam. And when this probability is calculated, the model can detect that either the message that the user is adding is spam or not spam. So that is why Naive Bayes is one of the best algorithms to detect this. Yeah, so with this formula, we can basically calculate the probability of our messages as being spam or ham. First of all, I would like to show you the demo of my project. This is a sample text message that I have found, and this is the interface of the project. We can see that the title is here. This is a text area for the user to enter any amount of SMSs, and we can just click on predict. And when we predict, it takes a moment to load, and then we can see here that our model is detecting that this message is spam. Yeah, so next we will take a look at the code. We are importing NumPy as NP and Pandas as PD. These libraries will help us to work on our data set and define use data frames for our data set. First, we are doing pd.read.csv. So this will help us read our spam.csv file. Spam.csv is basically our data set, which contains all the messages. So if we do df.sample, that is data frame.sample, you can see this is what our data set basically looks like. These are 10 sample messages from a data set. So here we can see that our data set contains v1, v2, and three unnamed columns as unnamed 2, 3, and 4. So yeah, and in v1, basically the classification is being done as ham and spam. The reason this is called as a spam message classifier is because we have only two outputs. There is just a classification between either our messages is being spam or either our messages is being ham. So yeah, when we do df.shape, this is the shape of our data set. That is, it has 5572 rows and about five columns that we saw here. First step in this project would be to clean this data, because we might have some null values, we might have some values that we don't need, and we have to make it easier for a model basically to be trained using this data set. And for that, we need to do some processes which will help our model to easily accept this data set. So first of all, when we do df.info, this will give us an information of our data set. What does it look like? So v1 has 5572 values, v2 has the same, and unnamed 2, 3, and 4 we can see have very minimal values, and their data types are given here. So first of all, as we can see that unnamed 2, 3, 4 are not serving a very big purpose, so we are good. So I'm directly dropping these columns by using df.dropColumns, and the column names are being specified here. With this, what will happen is that these columns will directly be dropped from our data set. The reason you're doing this is because they have low and mostly null values. Now when we do df.sample 5, so there these are the this is the basic sample of our data set right now. Now, V1 and V2 are not very clear, like what is the purpose these two column names are serving. We cannot be sure. So what we'll do is we'll use the rename function, and we're going to rename V1 as target. That will be our target classification, and V2 will be as text. Those that will be for the text messages. So now when we look at it, we can see that this is much clearer, as you can see that the text is being displayed here and the target is being displayed here. Next, what we are going to you do is we are going to give the values of spam and ham as 0 and 1. So what will this help us in doing is that when naive Bayes trains on this data set, it needs the input in the form of integer values or in labels, so that it can easily predict our further messages as zeros or ones, that is ham or spam. Right, so for that we are importing from sklearn.preprocessing. Preprocessing we are importing label encoder. Label encoder is, as the name suggests, it will label and it will encode the our target column, and all the labels in that will be encoded to zeros and ones. So when we do it, when we apply it on the target column, we can see that the encoder.fit transform, by using the encoder.fit transform function, we can just directly do df.head, and we can see that our target column has all the values as zeros and ones, and the text column is as it is. Next, we're going to check if there are any missing or null values in our data set. So for that, we are doing df.isNull.sum. Sum function will give us directly a summation of all the values by it, the count of all the missing values. So in my data set, there were none. There was no target. In the target column, there were no null values, and the text column, no null values. This was basically also because we dropped the three unnamed columns. So most of the values might have been there. So that is why we didn't get any here. Next, we are going to check for any duplicated values, if there are any duplicates in our data set. And you're going to use duplicated function, and then again we'll use the sum function. We can see by that we have 403 duplicate values here. So again, we're going to do df.drop duplicates and keep first. So what this will do is it will keep one original value, and it will delete all the rest of the duplicates. And then when we again do the df.duplicated.sum, we can see that there are no duplicate values. And now when we do df.shape, this is the final shape after data preprocessing. This is the final shape of our data set. That is 5,169 rows and two columns. Next step in this project would be to perform EDA. EDA is basically exploratory data analysis. This will help us to actually visualize our data further, and it will help us to understand what kind of data we are dealing with, what is the percentage of these data, what is the presence of ham and spam messages in this data. So it will again help us to train and build a model on that. So first of all, this is what our data set currently looks like. And when we do df target on the target, if we do value counts function, we can see that 0, that is the number of ham messages, are 4516, and the spam messages are 653. To further visualize this in a better way, we can import matplotlib.pyplot, and what will this do is it can help us plot a pie chart of this same data. So when we do df target dot value counts that we applied up there, we will use the labels as ham and spam, and we'll do autoPCT equals 2% 0.2f. what will this do is it will give us the percentage in two decimal places, so that is why 0.2f. and then when we use the plt.show function, we can see that our pie chart is being displayed, and the number, the percentage of spam messages 12.63 and ham messages 87.37. so now this helped us visualize that our data basically has a very big number of ham messages as compared to the spam messages, right? Next, what we are going to do is we are going to import NLTK. I had to install it by using pip install NLTK, and then PUNKT is basically a dependent library that we need for NLTK to run. What will NLTK now help us to do is it will help us to see the number of characters, the number of words, and the number of sentences in our data. So we can then use this to again get an idea of what our spam and ham messages look like. For number of characters, I directly use the apply length function, and then by using df.head, we can see that the characters are being directly displayed here. So for example, our first message in the dataset has about 111 characters. Now for number of words, what we did was that first of all, we are applying it on the text column, then we're using the apply function. And with the length function, nltk.words tokenize by passing x here, this length function will give us the number of words. So word tokenize, basically what it does is it takes the message and it will tokenize each of these words into separate tokens, right? So our message will be, suppose we have this go until Jurong point. So go will be tokenized singly, then we will have until, then we'll have Jurong, then we'll have point. This is the tokenization that will happen when we use nltk.word tokenize, and their length will be given us over here. So this is what it looks like. In numwords, we have about 24 words, you can see, for the first message. Next, for num sentences, we are just keeping the query similar, and we're just going to take nltk.sent tokenize. So sent tokenize is basically tokenization of sentences, that is division of our messages into sentences. So every full stop will be calculated, or every after every few words the sentence will be calculated. So what we can see here by doing df.head is that our messages have about two sentences, then second one has two sentences, the fourth one has one sentence. So that is how what num sent tokenize can do, right? So next we have we're just checking we're using the describe function to take a look at these num characters, num words and num sentences, and we can see that the average number of sentences in our messages characters is about 78, and there are about 18 words in these messages on an average, basically we're saying here, and 1.96, that is about two sentences, is an average number of sentences. Now we can also do this separately for ham messages and spam messages. So we'll just apply it on the target equals to zero. So the target column and zero will be specifying as ham, and we'll just check the num characters, num words, and num sentences. And dot describe will tell us that on an average, our ham messages have about 70 characters, 17 words, and about 1.8 sentences. For spam messages, again, if we do target equals to 1, we can see that 137 are the average characters in our spam messages, 27 words, and 2.9, that is about 3 sentences, is our number of sentences that are present in the spam messages. So this gave us an idea of the comparison between the ham and the spam messages, and we can clearly see that spam messages are comparatively longer in our data set, and the number of sentences also in our spam messages are pretty more. Next, what we're going to do is we're going to import seaborn, and by seaborn will actually help us to plot a histogram with of these num characters and num words, and we can see the comparison of this. So we're using sns.histplot because we are of course taking seaborn. So when we do df target equals to 0 on the column of num characters, and then we do target equals to 1 for spam messages on the column of num characters, and we'll just define this color as red so we can clearly see the difference. So we can see that yes, the number of ham messages are more, but the characters again when we see are more in our spam messages. So this red that you can see here clearly defines the conclusion that we came up over here. Next, if we check the same thing for number of words, so target equals to 0 and 1, and we'll just use it on the num words column, and then the color will be red. So we can see, yes, again, the number of words in spam messages are more as compared to the ham messages. Now we'll check if there is a correlation between these num characters, num words, num sentences, and our target column. So we're going to again use seaborn, and we're going to take a heat map here, and df.cor will help us to see the correlation of these. And what we can see here is that first of all, if we check for num words with num characters, so we can see that 0.97. So 0.97 is very closer to 1. So that means that num characters, num words have a very high correlation. And similarly, if we see for num sentences and num words, again, we can see 0.68, which is also pretty high in correlation. And with the target column, if you want to see, so num sentences, num words, and num characters. From these three, num characters again has a very high correlation with the target column. So basically, we can determine that num characters can play a big role in determining our message as ham or spam, right? So that is what we're understanding from here. So that we can use further to develop our model. Next, we have is text preprocessing. So Now we cleaned our data. We visualized our data. We did perform EDA. Next, we have to work on our text. So this text is basically what we're going to perform here is we're going to make our text lowercase. Then we're going to perform tokenization. We'll be removing any special characters from our messages. We're going to remove stop words and punctuation, and we're going to perform stemming. So I'll explain all of these to you one by one. So first of all, what I have done here is that I have created a function that is transform text. This function will help us perform all of these together. First of all, to lower case our complete text messages, we are going to take text equals to text dot lower. So this lower function will help us to lowercase all our messages. Next, to tokenize, for tokenization, we are again using word tokenize from NLTK. So when we do word tokenized on the text, our text will be tokenized into separate words. For special characters, what we're doing is we're taking a for loop, and if we're giving the if condition in this, and I dot is alna, basically check all the alphanumeric characters from our data set or from a text message, and what it will do is it will help us remove those. So yeah, so if you put it in the for if condition, it will help us remove all these special characters from our messages. Then we are going to remove stop words next, and we're also going to remove all the punctuation. So for this, what I needed was I had to download from NLTK the stop words. So what stop words basically does is I'll show you what are stop words first. These are basically all the words that are that help to make sense of our sentences or our language, but they do not serve a purpose based in the me in the formation of these sentences. So if we remove all of these from our data, it will the meaning will remain basically same, but any extra words can be removed, and this will be easier for our model training. So these are all the stop words, and I imported this from imports from nltk.corpus, import stop words and stop words dot words English. So when we select English, we see all the stop words from that are used in the English language. So by doing that, we again took a for loop on our text, and if our I is not in stop words dot words, and if it is not in string dot punctuation. String dot punctuation is all these punctuation marks that are present in the in our languages, in our messages. So if it is in not in either of these, then that will append in I, and this will give us our message free of all the stop words and free of all the punctuation. So our next step was to now we to remove stop words and punctuation. Now we'll do stemming. So stemming is basically just a second. Yes. So this is stemming. Stemming basically takes your word into its root form. So as you can see here, caring is when we perform the stem on caring, we get the output as care. So this is basically caring is a word, and care is its root word. So stemming will take all our words from our messages into a root word. So for that, I used nltk.stemPorter, and I imported Porter stemmer, and we created an object and Porter stemmer function. When we do ps.stem, it helps us to stem our messages. So when we apply this transform text function to one of our messages, as you can see here, this is the output that we are getting. So gonna becomes gone, home, soon, won't, talk, all the stop words, all the punctuation marks, for example, this question mark, all these words turned out into lowercase. Tokenization happened on them. The stop words got removed, the punctuation took place, and the stemming also took place. So this is basically how our text is pre-processed, and this is what we now we'll use this transformed text for our input. Now What we doing here is, first of all, I installed WordCloud. WordCloud will help us see what does basically the words in our text look like. So from WordCloud, when we import WordCloud, this is going to be the width and height of my WordCloud, and the minimum font size I've taken 10, and the background color is white. So when I generate a word cloud for spam messages, by using the generate function on the target column equals to one, and from that we're taking transformed text dot string dot concatenate. So what this helps us do is we can see that these are all the words in our spam messages that are very highly used. So free, call, mobile, text, please, reply, free. These are all the words that we can see mostly in our spam messages. And then similarly for our ham messages, these are all the words: go, got, come, one, need, time, want. So yeah, these are the ham and spam messages word cloud. Next, what we're doing is we are just using this transform text column again to see what are the highest what are the words that are very common in our spam messages, top 30 most common words. So for that, what I'm doing is I'm using seaborn, and we're taking a bar plot of this, and what we're doing is pd dot data frame counter spam corpus. So first of all, what we did was we created a spam corpus. In this, we took the target equals to one for our spam messages, and on the transform text function we applied the toList function. So toList, what it does it it does is it basically transforms all the messages from our spam into a list. So this list can be then saved, and then we can use this further to check the most common 30 words. And then when we apply the length function on this spam corpus, we can see that there are 9,941 words in our spam message. From these 9,941, we are taking the collections and we're importing counter. So counter is basically a dictionary to count the occurrence of each word in a message. So then when we apply this on the bar plot, and we're taking the rotation as vertical by using the plt.show function, you can see that these are the most common 30 words from our spam messages. And similarly, when we do this for our ham messages as well, we can see that these are the most common 30 words from our ham messages. So yeah, basically WordCloud showed these things to us already, but we can see their proportions also in a bar plot. So that is why just a visualization here. Next is finally our model building part. So as I already said that I am using multinomial naive Bayes, but how did I come up to that conclusion? That is what I'm going to explain to you here in the model building part. So first of all, from sklearn.featureextraction.txt, we are importing tfidf vectorizer. So tfidf vectorizer, what it basically does is it will help us vectorize our messages. But also the A good thing about TF-IDF is that it takes the frequency and also the importance of these words for us in our messages. So for our messages, the importance and the frequency of words both will be considered by this vectorizer, and then this vectorization will be done so that a naive Bayes can use these messages to train and then to predict. So with you're creating an object for TF-IDF, and you by using the fit transform function, we're taking the transform text column here and we're putting this into an array. So our yes, also the max features for TF-IDF that I have taken here are 3,000. So what will this do is that the most common 3,000 words from our whole corpus will be considered, and then that will be used for the prediction of this model. So yeah, and then the y will be for target dot values. Next, from sklearn dot model selection, I am importing train test split. So train test split will basically help us create objects for our data, and then basically we are taking your xtrain, xtest, ytrain and ytest, and by applying train test law dot train test split, we have x, y, test size equals to 0.2 and random state equals to 2. So text size equals to 0.2 basically means that 20% of the data will be left for testing, but the other 80% will be using it for training the model. And next, what we're going to do is now that we're going to, from sklearn.naive base, we're going to import Gaussian naive base, we're going to import multinomial naive base, and we're going to import Bernoulli's naive base. These three are different types of naive base algorithms that we can use. And sklearn.metrics import accuracy score, confusion matrix, and precision score. So these are the basically the parameters that we are going to use to understand which of these three can help us give a better output. So I'm creating their object here, and then we're going to use the fit function here. So GNB, that is Gaussian naive base dot fit. We're going to take xtrain and ytrain. We're going to create a function for prediction, and then predict, we're going to do it on the xtest. So then we're going to print the accuracy score, the confusion matrix, and the precision score of Gaussian naive base. Here we can see that accuracy score is about 87%. And the precision score is about 50%, which is very less. So Gaussian naive base has a very less precision score. Precision is basically how accurately is the algorithm testing or predicting what which messages are actually spam and calling them a spam, and which messages are not spam and still it is calling them spam. Confusion matrix also determines this. The false positives in this Gaussian naive base will be actually higher if we use it. So that is why we're not going to use this. Now, multinomial naive base had a precision accuracy score of 97%, and the precision score was 100, almost like 1.0, means it is very precise in determining if a message is spam or not spam. So, and as you can just see the zero here, this states that the false positives in this are zero. So if a message is not spam and then it is detecting it as spam, that is not happening with multinomial naive base. And this was one of the reasons why we are taking multinomial naive base in our model. Bernoulli's also performed pretty well. It had a 98% accuracy score and a precision score of 99%. So basically, the precision was comparatively less. So we went on with multinomial naive base. Also, I performed a model improvement, and that model improvement was that I changed the max features for TF-IDF. So first of all, when we did not take any max features for our TF-IDF, the accuracy score for multinomial naive base was around 95, but when we took that for as 3000, we got an accuracy score of 97%. And for Bernoulli's also, the accuracy score was around 96, and then after taking that, we got at 98. Next, just to now create, we're taking import pickle. So pickle.dump tfidf, we're going to open vectorizer.pkl in write binary mode, and then we're going to open a model.pkl into write binary mode. Vectorizer.pkl will contain a tfidf vectorizer, and model.pkl will contain our transform text model. So these two, when we take on our in our model, we are going to take these two files to create our app. So for our app, I'm creating an app.py in PyCharm. For that, I have imported Streamlit. Streamlit is basically our Streamlit is what is going to help us to create our app and to run it. Then we are importing pickle again. We're going to import string, we're going to import NLTK, and we're going to import stoppers and porter stemmer. Why did I import all these again here? Because I'm taking the transform text function directly over here. So what will happen is after taking the transform text function here, I would need all of these again. So yeah, and then we are taking TF-IDF into pickle.load. We're loading our vectorizer.ptl file into write binary mode, and we're loading a model of model.ptl file into write binary mode. Sorry, read binary mode. Then the st.title is basically the title of our app, that is spam message classifier, and input SMS is basically the SMS that we're going to get from the user in the text area. ST.text area, enter that message, and then if the ST.button button is predict, so if the button predict click is predict button is clicked, then what will happen is we're going to perform these four steps. The first will be for pre-processing. So we're taking an object transformed SMS. This will basically take our input SMS and put it into the transform text function. So transform our input SMS will be first go like will get through the transform text function. Then vectorization will happen. So we're taking the vector input as object, and the TF-IDF dot transform will help us to transform this SMS into a vector form. Then we're going to predict. So we're taking result equals to model dot predict, and we're going to take the vector input here. This will basically help us use the model .ptl file, and will help us predict. And then to display this, if our result equals to 1, that is spam, then st.header will print this message is spam, else st.header will print that this message is not spam. So yeah, this is basically what my project does, and this is how it works. I hope you guys understood and liked this. Yeah, thank you. Thank you.